We had a lot of discussions about Illinois, you know, and listen, I'm still an Illini. I'm going to be an Illini until I die.
Especially when I first got offered there, when it was my first offer, he was excited. He was like, man, what is it about the orange and blue? He was just talking a lot about it. But as I started getting more offers, we started weighing the decisions a lot. And I feel like it was just, he started to get more kind of like balanced and not so persuasive with Illinois.
You know, we still all love Illinois, but you know, the best fit for our son was Northwestern.
Northwestern was always by my side since the day they offered me. So I think that played a huge factor. I know I'm a big loyalty guy, so.
Northwestern, one is on the rise, I believe. They've gone to two consecutive NCAA tournaments. Academically, the school is great, it speaks for itself. Chris Collins, who I have had a relationship with for a number of years, and also with his dad, Doug, I've known for probably 30 years.
Seeing Boo throughout the years, Ty Berry, another name, Chase Audige, they were free. They were allowed to play more of a guard-led team. I feel like that was something that I wanted to do and something that would help me at the next level. I feel like in my role right now at St. Ignatius, I am more of a combo guard, so their style fits me great. And I feel like the coaches are great, and they push you to get better every day, which is gonna help me throughout my path.
You know, it just seemed like everything came together and they checked all of the boxes.
Staying close to home will also allow both sets of Phoenix's grandparents, all now in or approaching their 80s, to watch him play in person. Kendall's also come to the realization his alma mater didn't maintain as serious a pursuit of his son, so that the pressure is even greater in Champaign to win now and focusing on stocking up with more experienced players through the transfer portal. But his heart will tug at him and his stomach will be in knots for those head-to-head meetings.
I'm wearing a gray suit, bro. I'm wearing a gray suit and, you know, I'm going to be suited up and I'm going to be totally neutral. You know, I'm going to be hoping for the best. I hope Illinois plays great, but I hope my son plays greater.
There's always going to be an edge there. I just want to be able to play well against them and just be able to show my talent, show what I could do. Of course, there's a battle for Chicago's Big Ten team. So, honestly, I think Northwestern is it. So, we just got to prove that every day. As soon as I step on campus, or it even starts right now, I feel like I just got to prove that I'm a capable player and that we can win some of these games for Chicago's Big Ten team.
Between a 15-year NBA veteran supervising and pushing him through his workouts while dad and mom also make time for his younger brother who plays golf at Ignatius, Phoenix is well aware of the impact and effect the bloodlines, knowledge, and caring have had on the Big and Big Ten opportunity that lies ahead for him.
I've always looked up to my dad. I mean, I always wanted to be a D1 player, this is one of my dreams, I feel like. And my dad has pushed me every day through the workouts, gruesome workouts, through all the mental training and just film breakdown and stuff of that nature. I mean, it's been a lot, but it's got me to the level I'm at. So I'm very blessed to have a great dad, and he's been my driving factor through everything. And he's been alongside my mom. He's been with me the whole journey. So, I mean, I can't ask anything more from him. He's just been an incredible dad.